Hi, it's Lata Brouwer, and you are now watching Violin Lounge TV, where you learn to improve your violin playing with joy. In this episode, I'm going to answer a question from one of our viewers. And she commented on my video about the fourth finger phobia. I will post a link to it below. Her name is Pamela, and she comments, I'm learning to play beginning violin at 66 years of age, and the challenge of the pinky bow finger is tremendous. My pinky is very weak when I am trying to learn the bow hold. It slips off the bow and the knuckle sometimes straightens and locks up on me. Like you say, it's probably due to weak pinkies. I will attempt the pinky exercise. I actually have a free pinky training program in which everyone can join, and I will post the link to it below. And then you learn how to improve the strength, the balance, and the flexibility of your pinky to improve your bowing, and of course to improve your intonation, depending on it's the left or the right pinky. At this point, I would not like to lose my confidence. No pain, no gain, I suppose. Well, I always say pain, no gain. My bow pinky is definitely aching. Well, it's not good if it hurts, but what a lot of people do is, of course, your pinky isn't very strong as you're beginning, because in daily life, when do you use that pinky? And suddenly in violin playing, you have to do a lot with it. So it has to become not only stronger, but also you need to be able to make your pinky do what you want it to do. You need to train the coordination also. In this video, I'm going to go into your question of why the pinky slips away from the bow all the time. And it's not only a lack of strength, because a lot of people have their bow hold already a little bit this, so the pinky wants to, you know, lock. It locks very easily, so and it also slips off very easily, and most of the time to the front. So if you don't want that to happen, you should relax your pinky a bit, really make it flexible, maybe make it a bit rounder, so it doesn't lock so easily. But don't put too much tension on it, because then, you know, the tension, and then plop, it will go that way or the other way or whatever will happen. If we put a lot of pressure on it, it will, you know, slip away. Then, you see that even a round bow or an octagonal bow, it doesn't matter. Here at the frog, it's always octagonal. And when you put your pinky here on the highest side, then it can easily, you know, slip away to the front or to the back. But if you push your pinky, now don't really push it, but if you hold it a bit to the side, you see I'm not holding it here, but here, and it's just 2 millimeters, but it can really make a lot of difference, because then it can't, by tension, your pinky goes straight. Because if you put the tension on your pinky, it goes like this. And if you put it to the side a little bit like that, it doesn't really, even if you put tension on it, it doesn't go like that. And if you have it on top of the bow, it can easily go away. So it's a small tip, and it's just a couple of millimeters, which means that it's quite easy to apply, but it will, you know, solve this issue. It was an insight for me too, some time ago. So I hope this little tip will help you in combinations with the other pinky trouble, fourth finger phobia, etc. videos that I have made. Hope it's helpful for everybody watching this video. Do you like this video? Please like it and share it with your friends. If you'd like to receive more valuable and actionable violin tutorials, then please go to violinlounge.com. You'll find a lot more videos to help you. And you can also subscribe to my 2 free gifts for violinists worldwide. Thank you for watching Violin Lounge TV. Happy playing! Bye bye! Join me in the free workshop Weight vs. Pressure, where I teach you to play the violin effortless with a beautiful tone. Go to www.violinlounge.com/free-workshop
to get direct access to this workshop. I'm sure it will be worth it.